In this video, we will look at the FMI standard and at how it allows extending simulation capabilities to get more information and value. FMI is a standard that allows tools to communicate with one another by either embedding models inside one another or creating a link between them. FMI is the general term for the standard, whereas FMUs are the units which will be passed between software packages. An FMU is a collection of files and an XML file containing information on the model. The FMI standard can be applied to a wide range of tools, spanning many different industries from systems engineering to hardware-in-the-loop applications. There are two types of FMU, model exchange and co-simulation. In the case of model exchange, the FMUs do not have a solver attached. Instead, these rely on the importing tool's solver. In the case of co-simulation FMUs, a third-party solver is inside the FMU or available locally on the machine, and Simcenter Flomaster only queries results at a given time step. In Simcenter Flowmaster, we support a range of FMUs. We can export response surface models for model exchange FMUs and export a network for co-simulation. New in 2020.1, Simcenter Flowmaster can import both model exchange and co-simulation FMUs. Let's look at a simple example of FMI being used. One of the basic examples in the FMI standard is a simple bouncing ball. To import into Simcenter Flowmaster, we navigate to Launchpad, then to Component, and we click on New FMU Component. Here, we have a quick and easy wizard to import the FMU. Simply point to the FMU file, and then Simcenter Flowmaster will detect which version and type it is, and correctly import it. Once imported, the component will appear and be available to customize. Here, we can customize the placement of the arms or even add an image to the component. Once fully imported, we can drag the FMU onto the schematic and simulate. The start values have been brought into the data form for both gravity and coefficient of restitution. Now we can run a simulation. Opening up the dashboard, we can see some results for both the displacement and the velocity. We can see that the ball is dropped from a height of 1 meter and comes to rest roughly after 2.5 seconds. We can run this again with a lower coefficient of restitution and see how this impacts the results. Now the ball comes to a rest much quicker and is at rest around 1 second after the start of the simulation. This is a very simple example of how we can import FMUs into Flowmaster. So let's move on to a more complex one, where we import into Flowmaster a 3D vane pump model from Simcenter Aimsim. Through CAD import from Simcenter Aimsim, we can characterize the pump according to the geometry and gain more understanding of the individual pump rather than a generic pump using curves and surfaces. To export an FMU from Simcenter Aimsim, an interface block is needed, which can be found in the Interfaces menu under the Create Interface Block action. Once the interface block is created, the model can be exported. Using the export assistant, the FMU can be exported as a 32-bit co-simulation FMU. Now that the FMU has been exported, we can move to Simcenter Flowmaster and import it into our system. In Simcenter Flowmaster, we'll follow the same procedure as for the bouncing ball. We go to Launchpad, Component, and click New FMU Component. Now the FMU has been imported, we can customize the look of the component and add an image. The FMU component can be found in Components, User Defined. The next action is to add the component to the schematic and then connect it to the relevant unit converters. Once that's done, the network is ready to run, and we can post-process the results. Here, the pump speed is constant, and we are closing valves one after another. And you can see the flow moving between the lines. Bringing detailed component design from Simcenter Aimsim into Simcenter Flowmaster allows engineers to take advantage of the pump import functionality in Simcenter AIMSIM and the piping capability of Simcenter Flomaster, all in a single simulation. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit our website.